Hey everyone, this time on Tim Talks Audio, track creation and organization inside Studio One. If you record or program anything, it's based on tracks. Tracks are the paths where audio or MIDI are recorded to. In Studio One, you have audio, instrument or MIDI tracks, and automation. And in Studio One Artist or Professional, you also get folder tracks, and we'll get to those later. Creating tracks is very easy. You can start with the track menu on top and click Add Tracks to open a dialog box where you can add multiple tracks at the same time. If you need a quick single mono track, you can click this option. If you need a stereo, you would click this option. And a quick instrument track is just below, automation, so on and so forth. We're going to open up the dialog box and make a few at the same time. Tracks, add tracks, and it opens up the dialog box. We'll name it drums. We know it's going to be audio. Depending on your interface and many other things is the number of tracks you need to create. Let's say 14 in this case. I like my drums to be light blue. Can change the input to be mono or stereo. And they'll all be the same way. But you can change some to be stereo after you've created it. If you have presets, you can load them here. Studio One also comes with a number of presets. You can assign the inputs based on your interface and make them ascending from one till whatever. And the same thing for outputs. For now, I'll leave these settings as they are. Hit OK, and there's all my drums. Then I could go in and rename them as I see fit. I'm gonna do that real quick and fast forward through it. So here we go. I've named all my tracks, and as you can probably tell from most of these, they're gonna be mono, except I like to record my overheads and my rooms in stereo. And in the edit window, it's as easy as clicking this little circle. That instantly changes it from a mono track to a stereo track, and you can adjust your inputs from there. Let's say we also want to record the bass player at the same time. Another way to create tracks is to double-click under the last available track in the left pane. This opens up the dialog box where you can name, change your count, and colors, same way we did before. Seems like I had this one ready. Another way to make tracks really fast is to use the hotkey. The hotkey for adding tracks is the letter T. This opens up the dialog box, and as we did before, we can change our settings. If you've made too many tracks, it's just as easy by hitting Shift T, and the track you have selected will be removed from your session. If you need to add it back, you can either undo and it pops it right back, or press T again and add whatever tracks you need in whatever configuration. You may have noticed as I was creating tracks, I was making sure to color them. This is very important in keeping things organized. You can see here, I have just some blank audio in all of these tracks, and everything is still well organized, but it's a little cluttered and a little small. Here we can show off the importance of folder tracks. I can easily grab all of my audio tracks and bus tracks and effects tracks and MIDI tracks or whatever you want and add them into a folder. You would select all, right click, and pack folder. Now all of my tracks are in here and the color corresponds as well. You can name your folder and put it right back to your favorite color. Then, when everything's done, it's nice and organized. Now look how organized that is. Everything is packed together. It fills the whole screen nicely. And whenever we want, we can expand with this little arrow in the bottom left of the folder and see all of the tracks contained within. Another reason to stay organized is in your mix window. You can quickly find whatever fader you're looking for because they're all color coordinated by what works best for you. That's all for now. I hope you found this informative, and if you did, please like and leave a comment of what might be troubling you in your track creation and organization. Thanks for watching.